Fortran represents the most advanced coding system available today and is a forerunner of a universal coding language towards which we are working. Fortran permits a user to write or prepare a program in a language which is closely related to that of mathematics.
The release of Fortran in 1957 was a turning point in American history. Fortran was the first high-level compiler programming language. It was able to break the hindering bond between hardware and software. It greatly decreased the time and difficulty of writing a program. Improvements to hardware were easier and more efficient to make. I interviewed Tyler Agee, a software engineer, about what made Fortran a turning point in history.
My name is Tyler Agee, I'm a software engineer. Fortran was really the first kind of major actual interpretive compiled language. So what it ends up really meaning at that point for what it is it's instead of writing code specifically telling hardware what to do, kind of takes it a level away from that. So you can tell it, hey, these are the types of things I want you to do, and they can get compiled on different machines. So in that respect, it was also the decoupling of hardware from software, which is something that today we take for granted, to be sure.
Before Fortran, the same software could not run on different machines. Every program had to be handwritten for each individual machine. Then, with Fortran, the same program could run on any machine, which gave us the opportunity to develop hardware and software separately and at faster rates. Binary is the actual language of on and offs that computers use to follow directions. This language is extremely difficult to write in. The 6-character word binary takes 48 ones and zeros to represent, and much more to instruct a computer on how to spell it.
If you think about an on-off switch, you have to tell it every single on-off switch to do. But it's trying to do hundreds of thousands of them a second, so that doesn't really end up being all that great because you're trying to program way too much information for it to do. Whereas assembly takes it one level up, and you kind of go, okay, well, I want you to do this, I want you to add 2 + 2. And it takes a little bit of the binary away for you.
Assembly languages took the step-by-step binary and made it easier to read. This caused less errors in code, but still took a lot of experience and time to write in. When Fortran was released, it was the first high-level compiler language. This means that the programmer could tell the computer what he wanted a program to accomplish, and the computer would compile the necessary code to run the program. In 1953, John Backus asked IBM for permission to put together a team of programmers to find a more practical method to programming. The team consisted of programmers Peter Sheridan, Cuthbert Hurd, David Sayer, Francis Allen, Harlan Herrick, Irving Ziller, Luis Habit, Richard Goldberg, Robert Nelson, Roy Nutt, and Sheldon F. Best. This was the dream team of programming in the 1950s.
It was very informal, so that, for example, when I thought that we should try to make this Fortran system, I simply wrote a letter to my boss at the time, Cuthbert Hurd, and suggested that we do that, and he said, fine, we'll do it. The Fortran team, of course, was put together gradually as the problem got larger and larger that we had to deal with.
Fortran was the first of many things. It was the first compiler and automatic language, and was considered the first high-level programming language. High-level differs from automatic and compiler languages in that high-level is more of an idea. In this way, Fortran was high-level because it was an automatic coding language. Automatic programming was not thought very sensible during the 1950s, but is used now every day. John Backus was interviewed by Think Magazine in 1979. He was quoted saying, "Much of my work has come from being lazy. I didn't like writing programs, and so, when I was working on the IBM 701, writing programs for computing missile trajectories, I started work on a programming system to make it easier to write programs for the 701, and that wound up as something called speed coding."
We can't simulate a human programmer. They're taking this language and using this language to put a problem and getting an object code from the 704 that would even approach the efficiency of a human programmer. Like me, for example, I'm a great programmer,
So automatic programming language is something that you kind of tell it, here's what I want to do, and it goes and it automatically creates the code for you. There were some other things at the same time that were trying to do, trying to get to the same goal. The difference with Fortran is it was a programming language written by programmers for programmers. Basically, the guys that were in charge of it wanted to be lazy. They're like, you know what, we're sick and tired of having to code every single little bit of thing that we're gonna do. So we're gonna go back and go, no, we're gonna make programs to do our programming for us.
Our primary objective or focus was to permit people to concentrate on the essence of their problems and eliminate preoccupation with the mechanics of the computer per se.
Along with Fortran being a more speedy automatic coding language, it also was the first compiler language.
The interesting kind of with Fortran is that it was really the first true compiler language, meaning that you could write the same Fortran code and different machines would be able to compile it and run it correctly.
With Fortran, you could write the code for a computer and run it on different machines.
IBM had their 701, their 702, their 703 computers, and without Fortran, you actually have to write completely different code for each one. It's every machine was different. The code sets for the actual chips were vastly different and completely not compatible. Whereas with Fortran, now you have one language and it has a base specification, so everyone could write some sort of compiler for their chip.
Fortran was able to unify computing. It made computing more efficient and set precedents for the ways computers could efficiently communicate. However, in another sense, Fortran broke apart computing. It was no longer necessary for every company to manufacture entire computers. Fortran opened the doors for competition and advancement in every area of computing.
Instead of having each company have to make their own chip and their own operating system and their own programs and their own this and their own that, they could start to share and they could start to really, you know, compete in terms of, well, mainly financials. So in that respect, it was also the decoupling of hardware from software.
This allowed different areas of computing to be focused on. Now that scientists had an efficient way of communicating with computers, they could focus on making hardware more efficient. And now that there were compilers, programmers and scientists didn't have to worry about writing new programs for every new computer they got.
In a lot of ways, it allowed computer hardware to now be the thing making the advances. Because until then, they were kind of figuring out, okay, well, how do we want to give information to a computer and how do we want it to work? But now that you had something where you could just compile it and run on it anything, it didn't really matter as much anymore which one you had. And it didn't matter because you could run the same code. You didn't have to completely redo it all. You had your IBM 7000 mainframe and you wanted to get a second one or a third one, but they didn't make that anymore because IBM would just stop making them. So you had to buy a 7002. Well, before Fortran, you would have to rewrite everything that you were doing. Now it was you wrote it once and you just kept buying new hardware and it was fine.
Fortran was a turning point in American history. It made programming more efficient and opened the door for advancements not possible before. Fortran changed the programmer mentality from working on tedious instructions to creating efficient communication. It set precedent for new ideas and competition.
I think just generally for Fortran, it's almost not what Fortran did or Fortran itself, it's the ideas that it ushered in. Because to this day, a lot of the ways that we look at basic languages is based on this old idea of Fortran and how it propagated itself. Going back to kind of the compiler mentality of you write it once, you run it anywhere. So that mentality shift has still copied over, you know, 60 years later after it was originally written. We're still reaping the benefits of that kind of shift in mentality.
We just thought of it as something that would make programming the 704 very much less expensive and very much easier and more accessible. But we didn't have the slightest idea that it was going to cause such a stir as it finally did.
Keep that breathless charm, won't you please arrange it, 'cause I love you just the way you look tonight. Just the way you look tonight.